Hello friends, and I welcome you all at Circuits Bazaar. And in this video we are going to learn how you can make a fire detector alarm at your home. So first of all, let's see the component we are using. So this is MQ135 smoke sensor or air quality sensor. You might be thinking, why we are using smoke sensor? We are supposed to use the fire sensor. We are using smoke sensor because smoke can easily reach to the system, or you can say sensor, whenever there is a fire breakout, and smoke will be there only if there is a fire. That's why this sensor have 4 pin: VCC, ground, analog output and digital output. And this is blue color potentiometer, through which you can set the sensitivity of the sensor. Then there is a comparator IC, which is LM358. Then there are two LED, one is for digital output LED and another is for power LED. So this is about the sensor. Now next we have, this is a simple power supply which is going to convert 12 volt into 5 volt. So there are two connectors. This is 12 volt input and 5 volt output. So we are using 7805 voltage regulator over here, which will convert 12 volt DC into 5 volt DC. We are using, we require 5 volt because we are going to run a LED as well, and this sensor as well, because this sensor is working on 5 volt. That's why we require this power supply. The heat sink we are using to dissipate the heat in the environment. These are the simple like soldering connection, very very simple. You just like 2-3 soldering joints is there. Then this is single relay module along with drivers. We have made it, but you can buy it from Amazon as well. So this is 12 volt DC relay. So we are using these two transistor VC547 to drive this relay. These two transistor acting as a amplifier, which will amplify the signal coming from the sensor so that it can drive the relay. We are using diode as a back EMF bypasser. Then this LED will indicate whether relay is on or off. Okay, you can see that this is handmade module. But as I already told you, you can buy it from Amazon as well. Then this is the hooter, which is having three wire: the black wire, yellow wire and red wire. Black is negative and this yellow and red wire is positive. So it is capable of generating two type of sound. If you will connect ground wire and yellow wire, then it will generate a special type of sound. But if you will connect ground wire and red wire, it will generate another type of sound. Okay. Then this is a simple blue box in which we are going to fit our complete circuit. You can buy it from market. So before proceeding further, let me tell you, on our website circuitsbazaar.com, the complete article is given on this project. By reading this complete article, you can make this project at your home. So I have explained everything over here, like what is this smoke alarm and the components we are going to use, the MQ135 sensor, what are all the qualities of the sensor, okay, how you can fit it, then technical specification of this sensor, then circuit diagram. So here you will get the circuit diagram as well. So as you can see that in this circuit diagram, I have explained everything. Like this is 7805 power supply section, which will convert 12 volt into 5 volt DC, right? This is smoke sensor, which is having three pins: signal, ground and 5 volt. Then this is two transistor BC547, which is acting as an amplifier. You can see that the signal coming from this sensor is applied to the Bridgeway rectifier, Darlington pair of this BC547. And then this Darlington pair is driving the relay. So this is the relay sections. Like these are the pin 1, 2, and this pin, these are the relay pins. And I have connected a hooter over here. Okay, then this is a back EMF bypasser, a diode, and then this is LED indicator. We are using two LED indicator, one is for the relay and one is for the complete project, which is going to be on the top of the plastic box. Okay, so I have explained everything in this article, so you can just go through this article to get in-depth knowledge about this project. So some basic drilling we have already done on this blue color plastic box, so that it can save our time. So this is the connector, 4 pin connector we are using, 2 pin for to supply the 12 volt DC, and then 2 pin for the hooter. So you can see that I have mentioned plus minus on this, like hooter is also having plus minus and the power supply is also having plus minus. And 4 drills we have done in this box to take out connection from the PCB to the connector. And on the cover of this plastic box, we have done 3 drillings. One is for on off. This is a toggle button on off. Then there is LED indicator. Then over here we will apply the sensor MQ135. And some of the basic connections I have already done to save the time according to the circuit diagram. You can see the circuit diagram. The connections are very very simple. Okay, so I have just joined the wire, like there are 3 connections of 12 volt. I have joined them together. So that I can just put them in the power supply of this 12 volt to 5 volt power supply. And then there is a 5 volt connection, ground connection. So I have just connected all of them together so that it can save our time. So now I'm going to connect them on the power supply. So on plus 12 volt, I have provided a note. In the similar way, on plus 5 volt, I have also provided a note so that there will be a clear cut indication, and then there will be no error in connecting ground and plus 12 volt. Okay. So now you can see that 12 volt DC connection we have made properly. Here we are going to use a 12 volt adapter, but you can use 12 volt like battery as well. Now three wires I have connected to MQ135 sensor. One is plus, second is ground, and third is the data output, digital output. You can see here clearly. Now it's time to connect a 5 volt power supply to the sensor and this LED. This is the power LED actually, which is showing that you have applied power to the circuit. And now we are going to connect a 5 volt power supply from the 7805 voltage regulator to the sensor, which is MQ135 and power LED. So as I already told you, I have already done some of the connections to save the time. So 5 volt connection is also done. Now it's time to explain the relay connection. So I have applied plus 12 volt and ground, where plus and minus is written. Then this green wire is the signal wire, which is directly coming from the sensor to the relay driver circuit of relay. Then this black pin is the common pin of the relay. It is actually ground, right? And then on normally open pin, I have attached the red wire. Okay, so this is directly going to the hooter negative. The positive of the hooter we have already supplied from the power supply. Okay, for better connection of relay, you must know how you can make the relay connection. If you don't know, just write in the comment section. I will make a separate video on relay. So connection part is done. Now it's time to fix the complete circuit in the plastic box so that we can use this product in our home, or we can commercialize as well this product. So this is the sensor. We are going to fit this sensor over here with the help of heat gun. So let's take the heat gun. So this is how you can fix the sensor with the help of heat gun. So we are applying glue around the sensor so that it can fix properly. Then small glue we have applied on the toggle switch as well to secure the connections. So sensor is fixed, and this blue color potentiometer, you can later set the sensitivity according to your requirement. Small amount of glue we are also going to apply on the circuit as well so that we can fix them later. Now it's time to close the cover of the plastic box. Now we are going to apply the screw on the four corner of this box. Now we are going to provide 12 volt adapter over here on this jack. You can use battery as well. And on these two points we are going to connect the hooter. So this is plus of the hooter, then this is minus of the hooter. Now the connection part is done. So to generate the smoke, we are going to use this LPG for the fire, and these sticks. So these are very common in India, which is called agarbatti. Okay. So they are going to generate a very good amount of smoke so that you can do the proper testing of your project. Now let's fire them to generate the smoke.